Hi, and welcome to Tommy's Trade Secrets. This short clip is all about carpentry and how to do it right. Hopefully you'll find it useful. Take a look at the step-by-step guide, and if you like it, print it, keep it, and use it.
Hi, I'm Andy from tradesupermarket.com, and today I'm going to show you how to fit a Yale lock exactly like this one. Tools and materials needed for this job are flat-headed screwdriver, cross-headed screwdriver, hammer, chisel, drill driver, tape measure, pencil, small wood bit, spade bit, 32mm, and our lock. Okay, the particular lock we're going to use today is a Yale lock. Obviously this can be fitted to a left hand opening door or a right hand opening door. Now what we're going to do is measure the height that we're going to set our lock in today. Now obviously there's no said rule that you've got to set a lock in at a particular height. Obviously like different doors have different bars, different transom bars, and you can put the lock in to whatever height suits you best really. So what we do is we get a tape measure, and let's say we're going to set this lock in at a height of 1300 today. So what we do is just mark that at 1300. So there's our mark at 1300 there. And normally on with Yale locks, it'll tell you on the packaging exactly what your lock needs to be set in at. So this lock to the centre of the barrel needs to be set in at exactly 60mm. So we mark 60mm. We know we've got our height at 1300. 60mm in, and then what we do next is we get our drill bit, and our drill for this particular lock, it's a 32mm drill bit. Put this into our drill. Obviously this drill has got hammer action, screwdriver and drilling action. We just set that onto the drilling action, and then just make sure the door is stable. Put your foot onto the door. Obviously you can use wedges if you've got wedges. Place the drill bit onto the door, and then hold the door securely and start to drill the lock out. Right, now we've drilled our hole through the door. It's now time to fit our lock. As you can see, we're going to have to rebate this lock 3mm from the front face of the door. So what we do is just put a pencil mark on the door and just hold the lock up onto the line, and I can see that that front face has got to be rebated out 3mm. So then the next job is to actually get our barrel, and what we do is place this through the door and make sure it's nice and straight on the front side, and then just grab hold of the bar and make sure that's located. We then get our plate, hold it 3mm from the front face. We can always adjust this once we've done the screws up. This can be a little bit fiddly. If you just place the screws through, you'll soon pick up the holes that the screws need to go into. That feels like that's caught that one there. So, like I say, just hold that nice and square, and we get our flat-ended screwdriver and just tighten the screws up into the barrel. You will find that whatever door you're fitting it on, if you're fitting it onto a thinner door, you might well have to cut these screws down. If you just sort of just tighten them up slightly, don't over tighten them, because you might have to just make a few little adjustments to the plate. So we'll just tighten these up a little bit. That's it, and that's home there nicely. And as you can see on this barrel, the bar that comes through has got little tiny notches on it. Now, when you go to put your lock on, obviously if your door is thinner, you will need to cut these down. So obviously you'll need a hacksaw just to cut through these, because if you go and put the lock on and that bar is sticking out too far, you'll find that the lock won't push home. So you will have to cut these home. But obviously the door we're using today, that is ideal for us poking through as much as it's coming through. So the next job is then to get our lock. And as you can see, that's got a slit in the metal there, and that obviously locates into our bar coming through. And what we do is just push that on like so, and then I can see exactly where I need to rebate that lock now. So what I'll do is just draw around the lock with a pencil, and I'll take that off, and that's the bit I need to rebate out. And once that's rebated, that will send the lock back onto the plate, and then we can put our fixing screws through. Get a chisel and just make sure the door is secure. Just place this on the mark. Just tap that in. You just give it a light tap, just be careful, because you're so much on the edge of the door could actually, the timber on the door could actually split. So just slowly work the chisel down the line, like so, and then just get your chisel and just chisel that section out. Right, now as you can see, we've rebated that out about 3 mil, and our lock will sit flush in that now. So the next procedure is to get our drill, and then just put some screw fixings in, so we get our wood bit and just make some holes into the plate itself. And then just get a couple of screws, one and two, and this will just hold the plate onto the door. There you go, that's nice and secure there. And then just do that to the other screw. Right, okay, that's nice and secure there now. And then just check to make sure your lock's still square on the front face. Okay, now that your plate is located in position nice and securely, you then get your lock. This can be a little bit fiddly because you've got to get the bar section to sit in to the locking section. So just have a little tiny bit of patience with that. You'll find that it will eventually go in, like so. And then on the side, you've got two screw fixings. Now these will be cross-headed screw driver. So just get your screws in, like so. As you can see, the lock is in nice and securely there. And then just test it, just to make sure you're happy with it. And then obviously test the backside as well. So obviously if you want to go outside, you know, you can latch it and you can see the latch is on. So that seems to be working correctly. Right, now your lock is fitted. Now it's time to put your slam plate on. So the best thing to do is to shut the door and then just mark the top section of the lock and the bottom section of the lock, and then open the door again. And if you just place that on your penciled line, that is where the lock plate needs to go. So what we do is we draw around it, and then again we need to rebate this in to the door frame about 3 to 4 mil. Right, now we've marked this out with our pencil, just second check it, and that looks fine. So what we now do is then get our chisel, and then we want to take approximately 3 mil out of this frame. So a couple of light taps on there. And when you're chiseling out wood, for me to now to put my chisel on that and try and take that whole section out, that wood might well split. So what we do is just put a few grooves all the way down the section we want to take out, and then turn the chisel around, just slowly knock these pieces out. Like so. Right, now that's got about 3 mil taken out of that, we'll just put our latch plate back on just to make sure that sits in there correctly and that's nice and flush, as you can see. And then what we do is just get our pencil and make just some marks on there where our screw fixing is going to be. Again, get our small wood bit, place it on our pencil mark and just drill this out. Now in this pack we've got 3 screws, one is obviously longer than the other and I'll show you what that one's about in a minute. So what we do is just place one of the screws in at the top and the bottom, and these are crosshead screws, so we use our crosshead screwdriver and screw these in. Like so. Now actually within the plate itself you can see you've got another fixing hole there. Now you'll use the longer screw for that. So what you do is again just pilot this out with your drill. And then again put the screw in. Now this screw is obviously longer because you want this to really get into the woodwork. So if somebody tries to kick the door down, you've got this screw in which will protect the latch from moving this way. And obviously make your home nice and secure. So now that's right home, we just test our lock, make sure it shuts properly. You can see that shuts perfectly. So there's no movement in that door whatsoever. So we just undo it, try it again, push the locks down, just make sure it's night safe, which it is there, which means it's double locked. So just push the latch up again, and that's it, job done. Right, that's another job completed today. Remember, all your tools and materials can be purchased through tradesupermarket.com. Thanks very much for watching today, so stay tuned for more of Tommy's Trade Secrets.
I hope you found that useful. Now click below to find all the tools and materials you need for the job. There are products from loads of merchants, all at the cheapest prices on the web. Thanks very much for watching Tommy's Trade Secrets. Oh, would you mind rating this video and spread the word?